Good morning, students. Now, today in this class, we'll do the question of second exercise of surface area volume. Yes, last time, maybe as far as I remember, we did question number 5 or 7, sorry, 7, no, yes, 7. Now, in this class, we'll start from 8, then we'll go to 9, then 10, then 11, yes? That's all. So, what is the first question? The first question is, in a hot water heating system, there is a cylinder pipe of length 20 meter and diameter 5 centimeter. Find the total radiating surface of the system. Okay, now see, in a hot water heating system, there is a cylinder pipe. Now, first just imagine a pipe. In a pipe, both the sides are open or not. So, whenever we heat a pipe, yes, then only the carved portion of the pipe will be heated. So that's why here in this question, the question is find the total radiating surface of the system. So here we have to find the carved surface area of the pipe. So let us exercise 11, exercise 13.2, question number 8. Question number A. The question is length given. So length means height. Given height equal 28 meter. Then D equal 5 centimeter. D equal to 5 centimeter. So radius equal to half of D. That is 5 by 2 centimeter. Yes. 5 by 2 means 2.5. cm, height is 10 meters, so convert this one in meter, that is 0.025 meter. So this is the radius, that is 0.025 meter. Now, find the total radiating surface of the system. Therefore, carved surface area of the pipe. Surface area of the pipe equal 2 pi r h. And here pi what will be? Pi equal to the we will consider pi 2 by 7. If the value of pi is given 3.14, then only we will put the value of pi by 3.14. Otherwise 2 by 7. Radius 0.025 and height equal to 20. Yes, so it is 4. So this is 44 into 100. 100 means 0.1. Yes, 0.1. So what is the answer? 4.4 square meter is the answer. So this is the area of the radiating surface of the pipe. As the pipe, if it is not mentioned that the pipe is closed, until then we have to whenever we will find the area of the pipe, that means the carved portion. If it is mentioned that the pipe is closed on either side, then we will use the total surface area. Or in case of pipe, both sides are open, that is normally generally what happens. In case of pipe, both the sides are open, that's why whenever the question is find the area of the pipe, that we have to find the carved surface area of the pipe. Got it? So this is the solution. Height given, diameter given, so radius equal to half of diameter, then as the height is given in meter, so we consider or we convert the radius into also meter. The carved surface area of the pipe equal to 2 pi r h, 2 pi 2 by 7, r 0.025, h 28, then cancel them, multiply them, get the answer. Yes. Our next question. Find the lateral carved surface area of a closed cylindrical petrol storage tank
that is 4.2 meter in diameter and height is 4.5 meter. The number 2 is how much steel was actually used if 1 by 12 of the steel actually used in the wastage in making the tank. Okay, now there's two questions, sir. Two partings. First question is given that it's flow cylindrical petrol storage. But still, in the first question, the direct demand of the question is we have to find the car surface area, not the total. It is mentioned that the storage, the cylindrical petrol storage is totally closed at this cylinder. Still, we have to find the lateral surface area as it is mentioned in the question that we have to find the car surface area. So, first of all, what are the given data? Mention them. Given what? Diameter equal to given. So, first of all, height, the diameter. Diameter equal to 4.2 meter. So, what is radius? Half of diameter is 2.1 meter. Then, height equal to 4.5 meter. Yes? Height equal to 4.5 meter. Now, number one is find the lateral part of the same. Lateral surface area. Lateral surface area equal to 2 pi r h. Here also 5 is not given. So consider 5 into 2 by 7. 22 by 7. What is radius? 2.1. And what is height? 4.5. So it is 0.3. Then multiply again. 12, 125. 1.35, yes. 44 to 1.35, yes. 12, 13, yes, 135. Then if you multiply them, the answer is given in the book by doing the direct calculation. Here you get 59.4. I don't know, 59.4. So you get 59.4 square meter. Yes. 59.4 square meter, yes. Correct. Okay, then this is the lateral surface area. Now, what is the question number 2? Question number 2 is that how much steel was actually used if 1 by 12 steel was wasted? So, here let the first of all, so while making the tank, the very first time it is mentioned that the tank is totally closed. So, we'll use the steel to make the tank. At least we have to find the total surface area of the tank, and it is totally closed. What is the first question? The question is find the lateral surface area. That's why we are finding the lateral surface area. Otherwise, it is a completely closed cylindrical tank. So that's why, first of all, before doing the second question, second part of this question, first we have to find the total surface area of the tank. So number 2. Total surface area of the tank equal to what? 2 pi rh plus twice pi r square. 2 pi rh plus twice pi r square. Then 2 pi is equal to 59.4, we already got 59.4. Then here 2 into pi into by 7, then r square. R equal to how much? 2.1. So 2.1 into 2.1. Cancel them. 0.3. So after doing that, so this is plus. After doing the calculation, we got 87.1. I did the calculation more. What is it? It will take more time. So the total surface of the tank is 87.12 square meter. Got it? So first question is find the lateral surface area, and the second part we have to find out the metal use. Actually, the what portion of the work, how much metal is used to make the tank. Yes. So now second part. What's the question? equal to how much? 1/12 of the actual area.
X by 12.
So remaining portion.
Remaining
portion of the metal.
Portion
of the metal. Total minus wastage. 12x directly 11x. 11x by 12. So this amount of metal is used to make the tank. Now this is the area of the metal that is used to make the tank. So this portion is equal to 57.14. So according to question, 11x by 12 87.12. So x equal 87.12 into 12 by 11. So same thing here, what is the answer? 95.02. But the question is 95.04 square meter. So this amount of metal is used to make the tank. Understood? Give it 30. and here 2.5 for forming, here also 2.5 for forming. So what is the actual height? 30 plus 2.5 plus 2.5. That is the actual height of the cloth required to cover the lancet. These are the margins on the top and at the bottom. Yes. The students of a Vidyalaya are asked to participate in a competition for making a decorative pen holder in the shape of a cylinder with a base using a cardboard. Each pen holder has to be radius 3 cm and height 10.5 cm. The Vidyalaya was to supply the competitor with cardboard. If there were 35 competitors, how much cardboard were required to be bought for the competition? Okay, now here they are in the competition. The 35 students were participating and they were asked to make the pen holder, and the shape of the pen holder is given like a cylinder. The height of the pen holder is given 10.5 and the radius is 3 cm. So the Vidyalaya provided them the cardboard. They have to make the pen holder with the cardboard, and the Vidyalaya were providing them the cardboard. So how much cardboard were required for the students, were required for our students to make the cardboard. And here the 35 students are there. So first of all, we have to find out the area of one pen holder. Then if you multiply them by 35, that is the amount of cardboard, area of cardboard required to make the pen holder for 35 students. So here, first of all, in a pen holder, one side is closed and the one side is open. If the both sides are open, then we can't keep the pen there. It will fall on, yes? So while finding the area of the pen holder, we have to find the cap portion of the cylinder and the area of the base also. One side will be closed and the one side will be open. So here, first of all, what is given? Given height equal 10.5 cm, R equal 3 cm. So area of one pen holder.
Equal to how much? 226.
7920.15 square centimeter. This amount of cardboard required by 30 students to make the pen holder. Yes, so that's all for this exercise. In the next class, we'll do the questions of based on cone. Yes, and I have given a formula. Find the card surface of a cone. How to find the slant height? What is the formula? What is the relation between radius, height, and slant height? Yes.